So we're gonna go over how I set the lines for Asian style on a stem. So her body shape really her train is really short for summer. And I've clipped her body in a 10 because I want her to tan. You don't have to, it's just for summertime. I'll tie her ears up so you can see the lines. Trim's not done, I'm just packing out of here. So basically, when you're gonna do the flares, you need it to be tighter at the top here and bigger at the bottom. Now you can, depending on how much hair you have, you could leave this longer if you have tons of hair down here, but if you don't have very much hair at the bottom, you can just see the bottom of her legs, then you need to leave it a little bit shorter at the top to give it that illusion of more angle, right? So the trick is really to go down to about the elbow. Her elbow's right there. And start flaring out. Skimming is your best friend. So I'm gonna actually click down. And right about there, I'm starting to skim. I'm not doing this. I'm gonna go down and then start to skim off. Do a 10 at the top of her arm. So say I'm using a guard comb, and then I can put down this and actually follow on. I'm going about there and then I'm skimming. So that is just a really quick way. Can you see it? Yes. Really quick way to set in the front. Setting the bottom of the foot. I'm gonna make sure you can see this. Hang on a second. Whoop. All right. Next, you wanna set this bottom of the foot so that you don't accidentally take it too short. So, if you already have your foot cleaned out, a nice set of curves, and holding them, when you trim, you're always going to try and have a bit of an angle. So say this is the end of your toes. You're not going to trim like that, or that you're going to actually do like that. You see that? So you have this beveled effect. So
same way, I'm going to do kind of here. Good girl.
Don't mind me, I'm flipping swivels. A little bit harder. So first go around and clean up your little line. all you're going to trim is what you can just barely see sticking down. You're not going to be taking off a bite because you don't want to affect the lip. So now you have a start and a finish. Now this is where, if you like cheats.
I love cheats.
Okay, let's bring you back up a little bit. Okay. So what I love to do for a cheat is to use a skip tooth, like a 7-skip. Watch what it does. It's like an underneath the tooth. So your dog's gonna move. See, the shape is set pretty stinking nice without much finger, and that's from the skip tooth. I do a lot of this in the everyday salon, so this is a really good tooth. You can, of course, trim it completely by hand. I like to go back in and touch it with scissors, but honestly, when you're in a hurry, hopefully you can hear me. I'm just gonna steal you here. Fisher, are you right there? So again, the points on this foot right there is that you want it tight on the shoulder, and then I'm fading off because this is her elbow down here. Her leg is only this big, so I'm skimming off for this. You want it to come tighter here, but still fairly tight at the back of the leg. You're not gonna have, you can choose, I guess, but I have more of a bevel. See how good of a job I did. You wait there. Not bad. Not bad. Anyone? So see, even with the skimming, I haven't even touched this barely. Look how nice that did. So now we're gonna go to the back leg. You wait there. Okay, so now we're on the back leg. And so my upper lines are pretty obvious. Depending on how thick they are in here is what determines how far down you go. Oftentimes I like to blend it in. If I'm in a hurry, if I want to take my time, I'll scissor it. But for general everyday, so I'm actually touching this right now. Now you can build a shelf and build a booty. Asian style, I probably don't do it as much. The maggots gonna start. We're gonna set the bottom of the foot. line with the skip. Down here, you know, the bigger the exaggeration can be. I find it looks better to take it tighter up here. It's not so big and bulky when this is so short. And the thicker this thigh is, the shorter you can go. I'm just gonna tidy up and then show you the view from the back. Here, so you can show some points right there. So it's tight, it's a 10 here, it's going down into about a quarter comb, number four comb length here. Again, you could build the shelf or what you need. I have my own thing going on with the tail. I've actually started growing the tail up higher because she has a low tail set. Her tail base is right there, and I'm kind of growing it out and seeing what I want to do. She's got kind of a ponytail going on right now. So her back end looks like that right now. I need to do the other leg, obviously. In the past, I've taken this short and it makes it look way too bow-legged. So be aware of that, and that you're not taking it too tight here and then has a big puff of hair. So make sure this transition line is nice. And you can choose, sometimes I will join this in with a bit more hair. Just for summer, I find I tend to go the less hair I can. I need to clean that up a little bit. Right there. You can see I've got a shelf, so I need to, sorry if I'm making you sick. Oh, I don't have a curve. Okay, hold on. So the reason why it's showing that I need to. She's tired of standing. Easy, baby girl. Easy. I'm taking my curves in reverse to do this. I have to be careful because these are extreme curves, so it won't always fit what I'm wanting to do. Oops, sorry. Not following what I'm doing. Right. Better, right? Wait, boogers. Almost done, hey? Don't fall over.